have a chance to flatten the curve and prevent that from happening.
Jonathan Lemire, you're reporting on this White House all the time. I'll note that the last couple days, as President Trump's tone has turned a little bit better, we're going to talk about this a little more in the show, about his tone being a little more tethered to reality than it had been in the previous couple months. It's still the case that he's talking in a lot of vagaries about things like the ventilator issue, about things like the Army Corps of Engineers. Governor Cuomo says, hey, you got to send the Army Corps up here to start building these hospital beds and these ICU units. And the president says things like, you know, the Army Corps of Engineers, that's something we could do. But to me, it's like, it doesn't seem like we're, though his tone has gotten better, on these tangible things like the ventilator orders, the ICU beds, the Army Corps, it's not like we're seeing tangible movement of resources and time is wasting.
No question. John, first, just a quick update on something you said at the beginning. The governor of New York actually just put out, his spokeswoman just put out a statement saying that blanket quarantine shelter-in-place policies require state action, and so far that is not under consideration. So apparently he is suggesting that what Mayor de Blasio said earlier about New York City may not be in effect. Let's, of course, remember those two do not always communicate particularly well. So we'll have to see how that unfolds in the days ahead, but that at least appears to not be imminent. In terms of the White House, you are right. I mean, there's no question the last 48 hours or so, and we've done some real reporting on this, the president's tone has changed. And this is not something that should be applauded necessarily, or frankly, something that should be expected to continue. This is where he should have been all along. But he is certainly more clear-eyed about this. He is more somber. He has realized what a threat this is to not just the American populace, the economy, but also his own reelection chances. One of his senior aides, Jared Kushner, has been telling people he believes it's going to require a World War II-style national effort to get through this. But in terms of concrete promises, they have been few and far between. The briefing today, there's talk of, like, yes, we'll get ventilators, and yes, the Army Corps of Engineers will be involved, but there hasn't been any concrete promises. They say they're coordinating with the states. They still want to seem to defer to the states on a lot of this. He suggested that a lot of the governors have and the states have existing relationships with these manufacturers, and therefore it would be easier for them to obtain ventilators, let's say, than the federal government stepping in. But it's going to require a lot, and the action today, actually, at least the rest of the day, seems to be shifting more towards Capitol Hill, where there are negotiations. The Senate is going to meet, obviously, try to pass this first relief bill, but also the early stages of perhaps what could be up to $850 billion stimulus package for an economy that is going to need a lot of help right now, going to need a lot of shoring up. As yesterday, the White House basically unveiled social guidelines that will rewrite how Americans behave for at least the next 15 days.
Right. So, Tim Miller, you're out there. You're